Good evening from the Vitality Stadium, where Manchester United have beaten Bournemouth 1-0 in the Premier League this afternoon. United on the brink of a return to the Champions League. It did look until the very final seconds, really, that they would have actually guaranteed it today. But Liverpool rescued a point at Villa, so United need one more point from home games against Chelsea and Fulham to get there. It looks a formality now. Essentially, they need a result on a Thursday night this week to make sure they don't have to play on Thursday night next week. They got the job done here. Not a vintage United performance, had a real end of season feel. For those of you watching this on video, you can still see the Vitality Stadium pitch behind me and a few Bournemouth fans and families been having a kick around on the pitch for quite a while now. Players did their lap of honour. Gary O'Neill's been in the press conference saying what a successful season they've had going to Everton next week with no pressure on it. Bournemouth were safe before this, and they did have that kind of end of season vibe of a team on the beach, really. Their goal is achieved this year. O'Neill made five changes. It took them most of the first half to get going, and there wasn't a huge amount in the game for them, really. It was comfortable for United. Bournemouth's best spell in the first half probably came in the first 4 or 5 minutes. United started to build up a little bit of a head of steam after that, got the goal through Casemiro, a lovely chip over the top from Eriksen. Marcus Anasi stretched out, just got a foot to it, and Casemiro had to spin and volley it in from close range. A real acrobatic goal and a vibrant celebration in front of a buzzing away end in the stand right opposite me. For those who are watching the video now, a really good atmosphere in that away end today. Quite a few songs about going to Wembley in the cup final. Obviously, that's taken on extra significance with the City directing to the Champions League final in midweek. United now know they need to win that cup final to deny City a treble, possibly the most likely route to City not winning that treble. So the away end was showing how much they value that cup final now and how much they really want United to beat City to win the FA Cup, but also deny them a chance of repeating 1999. That was the winning goal, the only goal in the game. United were fairly comfortable after that. There was a couple of moments for Bournemouth, a bright start to the second half. Anthony giving the ball away, a bit loose in possession, which happened a lot throughout the squad, to be fair, today. De Gea making a good save from David Brooks, who was making his first start since recovering from leukemia. So a real feel-good story for Bournemouth with Brooks starting. And then De Gea with another good save late on from Kiefer Moore, saving with his feet. The clean sheet guaranteed De Gea the Golden Glove Award in the Premier League this year for the most clean sheets. A decent performance. There was one moment second half where Ten Hag rebuked him for going along with the goal kick when he wanted him to go short. But De Gea, faultless today in terms of his actual goalkeeping, no mistakes. Alisson conceding for Liverpool actually guaranteed him the Golden Glove Award. But another clean sheet to add to the record for him this season. And United defended pretty well throughout, to be fair. A solid performance in terms of the defensive efforts. I thought Victor Lindelof was really good again, really impressive, defended solidly. He's clearly leapfrogged Harry Maguire in the pecking order now. Hard to see how Maguire gets a game unless United secure Champions League football on Thursday and he gets a run out against Fulham on the final day. But in a way that only cements his status as fourth or even fifth choice centre-back. The one area you might be looking at a change for in the next week or so is in attack, and I thought the front three were not great today. Martial was first to come off after 57 minutes. I actually thought he was the best attacker for United. Linked the play really well. Didn't have many chances really, but he was better, I thought, than Sancho and Anthony. I thought both the wingers were fairly disappointing again. Weghorst came on for Martial. And to be fair, United were better with Weghorst on the pitch. He did force Neto into a decent save. And he just brought more energy to that forward line. So I'm not sure we'll see him starting again, but it shows that in the last three games he might still have something to offer. Obviously, Rashford missed this game through being ill. I'm sure he'll come back into the side on Thursday night if he's better and maybe come back as a number nine. Sancho next to go off. Garnacho came on for him, and Garnacho did one piece of skill just in front of the dugouts where he completely bamboozled Jefferson Lerma and left him trailing in his wake. And that was his real moment of impact, really. I thought Sancho was ineffectual again. Looks really low on confidence and low on form at the moment, not contributing an awful lot. And I think Garnacho, over the next couple of weeks, is really going to be pushing for a start. Whether that's in the cup final, we'll see. But certainly against Fulham, on the last day of the season, you could see Garnacho starting ahead of Sancho. Anthony lasted until the final few minutes. I didn't think he was great either, really. Like I say, gave the ball away a few times. He had a couple of dangerous attacks in the second half. Every time he looked to do the same thing, he made it obvious he was going to cut inside, and it was simple for Bournemouth to get players back and get a block in. But result was all that mattered. United on the brink now. Like I say, one more point needed to guarantee a return to the top four. It would have been done today, but for Firmino's equaliser at Anfield. But Liverpool dropping points pretty much guarantees it now for United. You would be astonished if they lost at home to Chelsea and Fulham. Really good scenes in front of the away end opposite me at full time. The United were wearing their lime green kit today. They started the season in that lime green kit away at Brentford in mid-August when they lost 4-0. This was a better performance without being brilliant, but the fact they got over the line and won it 1-0 shows how much they've improved as a football team this season and in terms of grinding out and getting results. Now they need just one more result to make sure of that Champions League return next season.